Dear panelists, dear Mr. Challas, did I pronounce it correctly?
Yes, perfect. I would prefer to call me
Okay.
George, though, and Yorgos, but
George,
please feel free to
okay.
call me anyway.
I would like to thank The Economist for organizing this event and dedicating one of the panels to the position of Croatian tourism within the Recovery and Resilience Facility. As we all know, Croatian GDP, and you mentioned it, relies quite heavily on the tourism revenues, and therefore it is clear that tourism must be assisted in its recovery and resilience building as much as possible. Last year, Croatia recorded a serious decrease of overnight stays in commercial accommodation capacities by 50% compared to 2019. And this year, we are still faced with a more unpredictable situation in the tourism and travel sector than we had hoped for. We believe that investing in tourism now will provide long-term benefit to communities, visitors, and businesses through all Europe. And our investments in tourism from the recovery and resilience facilities have two main goals. First, assisting quick recovery of the hardest hit sector in the global economy, also producing beneficial effects on connected economic activities. Secondly, directing short and medium-term investments towards our strategic goal, a sustainable tourism ecosystem. Our National Recovery and Resilience Plan is an opportunity for a strategic push forward with a sustainable financial basis. With the help of reform and investments through medium and term goals and specific measures that will contribute to a green and digital transition, we plan to address the following strategical challenges of the Croatian tourism. An insufficient level of tourism sustainability reflected in the uneven seasonal and territorial distribution of tourist demand, setting Croatia among countries with the highest index of tourism intensity in the Mediterranean region. And an insufficient level of quality and balance of the accommodation capacity structure, since hotels in Croatia represent only 11% of the total accommodation capacities. The overall reform will support sustainable tourism through green and digital transition, and this will be elaborated in our new strategy for the development of sustainable tourism until 2030, and the national plan for the development of sustainable tourism from 2021 until 2027. The reform will support the improvement of businesses' environment through additional adjustments of legislative framework to reduce the administrative burden and to improve the tourism sector competitiveness. To achieve full impact, the reform will be complemented by necessary public investments, which will contribute to regional diversification and destination specialization, as well as private investments that will accelerate the green and digital transition in tourism sector and improve the competitiveness and resilience of businesses throughout the tourism value chain. The Recovery and Resilience Plan and funding available through the Recovery and Resilience Plan are a very important step forward in our strategic repositioning of Croatian tourism. As already mentioned, we will continue with this important work through the implementation of our new sustainable tourism strategy as a long-term framework for the tourism development. However, our first objective now is to employ the full potential of the EU budget to mobilize investment and front-load financial support for the sector in the crucial first years of the recovery. Thank you.